This video is to allow you to correct your homework for section 2.3.4. So the first thing they want you to do is look at this generic rectangle. What two numbers are being multiplied using this rectangle and how can you tell? So what you're looking for is there must be a two-digit number times a two-digit number where you're going to get these values inside your generic rectangle, and there's only one combination that will make that work. So you may want to start with the idea of the 6. The only factors that would equal 6 would be 6 and 1 or 2 and 3. Well, you can't use 6 here because 6 times no whole number will give you 20. So you could consider trying 6 and 1 here, but then what you find is that doesn't work either. So once you end up analyzing it a little more closely, you find out that it does not work. So what you end up having to find is that it should be 50 plus 2, meaning 52, times 13, which would be 10 plus 3. And that works because 10 times 50 would be 500, 10 times 2 gives you 20, 3 times 50 gives you 150, and 3 times 2 gives you 6. So again, you may have to do a little trial and error to figure that out and to show that it works. So then what two numbers are being multiplied? 52 times 13. And then how can you tell? You should put some type of an explanation there. Maybe you can show the other possibilities that you tried. Maybe you could show that, you know, these do indeed give you the inside values in your generic rectangle. Then they want you to write the product as a sum of areas and find the answer. So 52 times 13 would equal the 500 plus 20 plus 150 plus 6 equaling 676. And then now they want you to use the distributive property to write an equation that shows that the product is equal to an expression with parentheses, multiplication, and addition. So in other words, 50 plus 2 in parentheses times 10 plus 3. And the reason that this shows you the distributive property is because 50 times 10 gives you 500. And then 50 times 3 gives you the 150. 2 times 10 gives you the 20. And 2 times 3 gives you the 6. So when you write this in this way, basically, each term has to be multiplied by, you know, for example, the 50 has to be multiplied by both the 10 and the 3. The 10 has to be multiplied by both the 50 and the 2, and so on. And, of course, that still equals 676. Then, for 287, you have to look at the data that they're showing you and decide which would best represent the data and then actually display the data. So they're talking to you about dot plots, bar graphs, histograms, and stem and leaf plots. So what you would find is because the data repeats, there's a lot of repeated values in here, and they're all very close in value, dot plots would be the best way to represent it. So when you do that, you need to have a title on it, and then you need to have a label on the bottom, like boot sizes. And of course, 8 comes up 5 times, so it should have 5 dots. 9 comes up 3 times, should have 3 dots, and so on. You might also talk about why other representations would not work. So a bar graph is usually used for categorical data, which we have numerical data. Histograms are used when you have intervals and the data is not so close together. And stem and leaf plots, again, are worked when you have things like 10s, 20s, 30s. All of these are, again, very close together and wouldn't make sense in a stem and leaf plot either. Then you have to figure out the missing values in these number lines and then make sure, again, you explained how you got those values. So one way you can do it is to show that you would take 20 minus 12 and get a difference of 8. And then since there are two spaces between 12 and 20, 8 divided by 2 means you're going by 4s. So you should say something in there about how you found out that you were going by 4s. And of course, adding 4 to 12 would give you 16. And then you'd have to go back to the left of 12 as well and fill in all those missing numbers. But again, you should have more than just this. You should explain how you figured out it was going up by 4s. Same thing here. You have 60 minus 10, which is a difference of 50. And you're looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spaces. 50 divided by 5 would be 10, so you're going by 10s, and then fill in your missing values. Here you have 41 minus 13, which would be a difference of 28, and you're dividing by 4 spaces, so you're going up by 7s. So again, have more than just this. Make sure you've explained why you knew you were going by 7s. And then here you're going up by 5s. Here you should make sure that you show how you got these missing values. So we know that 8 times 4 would give you 32. So 3 times 4 would give you a missing value of 12. Here you could think of this as 100 divided by 10 gives you 10. So 80 divided by 10 gives you 8. You could also think of that as multiplying by 1/10, because dividing by 10 is the same as multiplying by 1/10. And here, 2 times 125 gives you 250. So 1 times 125 gives you 125. For these, you should show that you lined up your decimal points, and you should show all your work. So again, it tells you to not do it with a calculator, but make sure you're showing your work. In addition, for something like B, make sure that you're putting in those extra zeros to do your subtraction, because you cannot take away 375 thousandths without putting in those zeros, showing your borrowing or regrouping, and then getting your answer. So I will show you the answers, but again, you need to show all of your work for those if you want credit for those. Same thing here, 90 would be changed to 90.000, 90 and 0 thousandths, so you can show your regrouping.